हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल। आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस मैट्रिक्स स्पेसेस पार्ट टू। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल इंक्लूड यूक्लिडियन प्लेन आर टू एंड टैक्सी कैब मैट्रिक। इफ़ यू लाइक माय वीडियो प्लीज़ डू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल एंड डोंट फॉरगेट टू प्रेस द बेल आइकन इन ऑर्डर टू हैव द अपडेट्स ऑफ अपकमिंग वीडियोज़। द यूक्लिडियन प्लेन आर टू। Let x is equals to r2 be the set of all ordered pairs of real numbers. D be the function defined from r2 cross r2 to r, defined as dxy is equals to square root of x1 minus y1 whole square plus x2 minus y2 whole square for all x is equals to x1, x2 and y is equals to y1, y2 in r2. First property is to check non-negativity. Clearly by definition, square root is a non-negative number, so dxy is greater than equal to 0. Next is coincidence. For any x, x1, x2 and y is equals to y1, y2, dxy is equals to 0 if and only if square root of x1 minus y1 whole square plus x2 minus y2 whole square is equals to 0. If and only if x1 minus y1 is 0 and x2 minus y2 is equals to 0, which in turn will give you x is equals to y. Next property is symmetry. So for all x in x1 is equals to x1, x2 and y is equals to y1, y2 in R2, dxy is equals to square root of x1 minus y1 whole square plus x2 minus y2 whole square. On interchanging x1 and y1, it will not impact the square. So y1 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus x2 whole square, which will be equal to dyx. So symmetry is also satisfied. Next is to verify triangle inequality. For that, we will suppose three points in the plane R2. X is equals to x1, x2, y is equals to y1, y2 and z is equals to z1, z2. Then considering dxy, we will have square root of x1 minus y1 whole square plus x2 minus y2 whole square. Adding and subtracting z1, z2, we will get x1 minus z1 plus z1 minus y1 whole square plus x2 minus z2 plus z2 minus y2 whole square. Substituting A as x1 minus z1, B as z1 minus y1, C as x2 minus z2 and D as z2 minus y2, we will get, this will be equal to square root of a plus b whole square plus c plus d whole square. Now here important thing is that we are using one inequality which is mentioned at the bottom of the screen, in which square root of a plus b whole square plus c plus d whole square will be less than equal to square root of a plus c whole square plus square root of b plus d whole square. This you can verify by substituting some values in it. So dxy will be less than equal to square root of a plus c whole square plus square root of b plus d whole square using the inequality. Now substituting back the values of a, b, c, d, we will get it will be equal to square root of x1 minus z1 plus x2 minus z2 whole square plus square root of z1 minus y1 plus z2 minus y2 whole square, which will be equal to dxz plus dzy. Now due to inequality sign in between, the sign of inequality will be there and dxy will be less than equal to dxz plus dzy, and hence we have verified all the properties. Therefore D is a metric on R2 and the ordered pair is the metric space. The metric D is called the Euclidean metric on R2 and the metric space is called the two-dimensional Euclidean space on R2. After Euclidean metric, we have taxicab metric on R2. Let R2 be the set of all ordered pairs of real numbers and D be the function defined from R2 cross R2 to R, defined as dxy is equals to modulus of x1 minus y1 plus modulus of x2 minus y2 for all x is equals to x1, x2, y is equals to y1, y2 in R2. Clearly by definition, again as in the previous example, D will be the non-negative function as modulus is always non-negative function. Second is to check the coincidence. Coincidence for all x is equals to x1, x2, y is equals to y1, y2 in R2, substituting dxy is equals to 0. Modulus of x1 minus y1 plus modulus of x2 minus y2 is equals to 0, which in turn again will give you x is equals to y. Next is to check the symmetry. For x is equals to x1, x2 and y is equals to y1, y2 in R2, dxy is equals to modulus of x1 minus y1 plus modulus of x2 minus y2. modulus will not be impacted if we are interchanging x1 and y1. So it will be equal to y1 modulus of y1 minus x1 plus modulus of y2 minus x2, which will give you dyx. So the three properties are satisfied. Last is to check the triangle inequality. We are taking x is equals to x1, x2, y is equals to y1, y2 and z is equals to z1, z2 belonging to R2. Then dxy is equals to modulus of x1 minus y1 plus modulus of x2 minus y2. Similar as the previous example, adding and subtracting z1 and z2, we will get x modulus of x1 minus z1 plus z1 minus y1 modulus plus modulus of x2 minus z2 plus z2 minus y2 modulus. Applying the inequality of modulus, we will get modulus of x1 minus z1 plus modulus of z1 minus y1 plus modulus of x2 minus z2 plus modulus of z2 minus y2, which is equals to modulus of x1 minus z1 plus modulus of x2 minus z2 plus modulus of z1 minus y1 plus modulus of z2 minus y2, which is equals to dxz plus dzy. And hence all the properties are satisfied, therefore D is a metric on R2, and this metric is known as taxicab metric. We can observe geometrically also this metric is also called Manhattan distance, which is equals to length of all connecting paths between two points A and B along horizontal and vertical line segments without going back, like we are going by car in lattice like street pattern. Thank you so much for watching my video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.